Hello. In this video, we're going to be looking at how to use mock and patch with Python code for testing your code, with particular emphasis on how you can test your code offline, even if you're writing some web-based code. So what we're going to be doing is looking at, we are going to be using mock and patch to put in some substitute data, basically. So what I'll do is I'll disconnect my internet connection and I'll show you how I can still test a script I've written that uses requests. So all we're doing really is substituting data in our Pytest. And notice how I said Pytest rather than unit test. Okay, so very quickly, I'm just going to run through this code. This code uses requests. I've just used any old URL, mockaroo.com. If you haven't used mockaroo before, check it out, it's quite useful. Anyway, first function, def fetch underscore net. And what it does is it gets a URL. It goes off and fetches that using response equals requests.get. And we're just passing in the URL. So the most basic get request. Then we're saying if the response code equals 200, then return ABC, the string ABC. Otherwise, it's going to return BCD. You'll see why this will make more sense in a minute. So this is just a function to go to a URL and get the response. Hopefully you get 200. Next, another function, which is called parse. What parse does is it goes off and gets the returned response from the first function, and all it does is it adds on the string 123. So it's just taking the response from the first function and doing something with it, and then it's returning that as the answer. So I think this is probably about as simple as I can make it. So let's just look at how we can run this, and because I've not actually put in a print statement, nothing's happening. So let's just do print, and then we can just say pass with a pair of brackets, parentheses. Now if we run it, we've got ABC 123 because it got a successful response from https www.mockaroo.com because I'm connected to the internet. Now, say you were developing a web scraper or some code offline and you wanted to be able to test function two, but you weren't able to get a successful response from your first function. This is where mock and patch will be really useful. So let's have a look at that. Just wanted to mention this book as well. It's been quite useful. Python testing with Pytest. Mock objects are sometimes called test doubles, spies, fakes, or stubs. Between Pytest's own monkey patch fixture, covered in using monkey patch, and mock, you should have all the test double functionality you need. This is chapter 10, probably best not to go straight there because it relies on a project all the way through. So that's quite a useful book if you're interested. Okay, so what you need to create is a directory called tests below your directory where you've written your code, ideally. You can make it the same, but the convention is to make a separate directory called tests. Mock and patch. So what I'm going to import is from, although we're going to be using Pytest, you have to import mock and patch. Oh, sorry. You have to import patch from unittest.mock. Then, because my code is in a different directory, i.e. the one above, effectively, that's as if that dot there is actually replacing the forward slash, really. So what we're saying is from app. So the directory above is called app. My file, my code is called fetch underscore ww. And I'm importing the parse function, which is, if you remember, it's the second function, function two. Right, this line will be new to you if you've not used patch or mock before. We decorate our function with at patch. So what we're doing is we're saying fetch www, which is our function. We're prefixing it with app.fetch as per the lineup here. And then we're specifying the actual function that we want to decorate, which is function number one in our code. And then we're creating a function, a test function, So the convention is to call your test function the same as your actual function, same as the function it's testing, but you just prefix it with test underscore for it to run in PyTest, for PyTest to find it. Then you need to put in mock underscore get. So normally with a test function, you would leave those parentheses empty, but here, because we're using mock in patch, we put in mock underscore get. Now what that's going to do is that's going to substitute the more. So on here, what it's going to do is it's going to substitute def instead of what it would return if it was behaving normally, as I just showed on the previous screen. Then when it's going to do the assert, so for every test has some kind of assert, and you use the assert method with, you use assert with parse, which is the function that we wrote in the first file. And we say the function in the first file, once it's got the mock data from the function, then it should equal def 123. So this is probably the easiest way to view what I've written here. So we've got the functions, fetch.net and parse. And then we're just printing at the end. That's just for demonstration purposes, really, so that can go. So for testing, you can see the little green tick there. It's already worked, but that's giving the game away, isn't it? So what you do is fetch www. So that there matches the name of your file, but don't use the .py on the end. And then, so treat the dots on this line here. Treat the dots as effectively as forward slashes. And so let's run the test. So within VS Code, if I bring up my activity bar, and you get the little test tube thing testing. And I'm just going to run it again, and you should get the circles, the spinning circles when it's running. There we go. So that test has worked. Now what I want to show you, if I run PyTest, what will happen there? Yeah, one passed. So you can run it command line as well. You don't have to use the VS Code extension. Right. Now, supposing, just to prove that this actually has some real world benefit, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to disable my internet connection, so it's connected, and then I'm going to run the test again, refresh, and the tests successfully pass, all of them, they all pass, and that is because I no longer go off to the internet to get to fetch the URL mockeroo. Instead I just pretend that I've gone to it. So patch and mock is basically, mock means it's pretending to go and get the response, and it's just substituting in def. So if I was to put in def into function 2, which is called parse, I would actually just be putting in def, and then I'm adding 123. So this function here is being passed the mock value of def. So I think that's clear enough. I hope it is. If any questions, then give me a shout and I'll do another video. But for now, this is just kind of a get started with mock and patch. And if you like the channel, don't forget to subscribe, thumbs up, and all the usual things that all the YouTubers tell you. So thanks for watching. See you again. If you want more information on Visual Studio Code and Python testing, code.visualstudio.com/docs/python-testing. And one good tip here, actually, it's the tip about sometimes tests placed in subfolders aren't discovered because the test files cannot be imported. To make them importable, create an empty file named dunder.py. Plenty more information on that page. If you enjoy these videos, then please feel free to consider contributing to the channel via patreon.com/drpy. And you can pay as little as £3 per month, which will really help me out making these videos and the time that I spend on them. So thanks for that.